Do you sometimes doubt yourself when making decisions? If you do, then what you're about to learn has the power to change your life.
Let's see, I could start this course on the 5th, or...
When should I launch this course? When should I launch my course?
Death? What does that mean? Hello, this is Bed Bath & Beyond, customer service. How can I help you?
Hi, I'm Sharla Jacobs, and you're watching Thrive Academy TV. And in this episode, you will discover three strategies for overcoming self-doubt and facing each decision with confidence and clarity. As a mentor to thousands of coaches and holistic practitioners, I can tell you that great decisions are at the root of creating a successful business. The decisions you make can make you a better person, a better partner, a better parent, a better leader, and allow you to build your communities, earn a high income, and the list goes on and on. And the biggest obstacle you can often face when making a decision is self-doubt. So where does self-doubt come from when trying to make a decision? Well, we found it comes from the fear of making a bad decision. I mean, what if you make a really bad decision that could put you in a really bad situation that you will regret for the rest of your life? This kind of fear can be paralyzing. I mean, you might even do anything to distract yourself from having to face that type of decision. At the time, the safest course of action might seem like not making a decision at all. But the irony is that if you're frozen when faced with a big decision, or if you're avoiding it, you actually lose the power to make great decisions, and you're more likely to make a poor decision. And then if you do make a poor decision, you're more likely to doubt yourself the next time you have to make a decision. And the cycle of self-doubt becomes stronger and stronger. So let's break that cycle. So here are three strategies to overcome self-doubt and make great decisions. Strategy number one, let go of your fear of making a bad decision. When you're frozen by self-doubt, it's usually because you're trying to avoid something bad from happening, right? Once you start thinking about what you don't want to happen, the fear can become paralyzing. Back in the days where making a decision would sometimes paralyze me, I would feel like I was living in a dog-eat-dog world where the wrong decision could mess up my entire life. Like even if the wrong decision was about what to wear to a client session.
Nope. Not professional enough. No, way too stuffy. First impressions are everything, and if I don't get this right, my client might want to cancel, and she might leave a bad review, and then everyone will reject me. Then I'll lose my confidence, and I won't be able to get any clients, which means I won't be able to make money, and then I'll have to get a job I hate. Oh my gosh, what if I lose my job, and then I won't be able to pay rent? If I can't pay my rent, then I'll end up homeless and die cold and alone on the streets.
Does your mind ever take you down a rabbit hole like that? Spiritual mentor Byron Katie says the worst thing that can happen in life is a belief. We believe this to mean that the pain of making a bad decision has actually little to do with the bad decision and is instead because of the belief or the story that you tell yourself about the decision. Maybe you've told yourself things like this, like, I trusted myself once and I failed, or that was so stupid, or I made a really bad decision, or I can't trust myself again, or I'm a failure, I'm never gonna succeed. What about this? What if instead of beating yourself up for the stupid decisions that you've made, tell yourself something different? You see, when our boys were little, Jesse used to whisper these things in their ear every single night. We would say, we love you no matter what you do, no matter what you say. We will always love you. We live in a friendly universe, which means that everything that happens is always happening for you and never against you. If it feels good, it's here to support you. And if it doesn't feel good, it's here to help you grow. But it's always a good thing and it's always a gift. So the more you hear yourself saying something like this, the more you'll believe it. And the more you believe it, the more you'll see evidence of it. And the more evidence you see that you are loved no matter what, that every decision that you make brings you to greater support or greater growth, the less you'll fear making bad decisions. Because if this statement is really true, then you can't lose. You're not stupid and you can trust yourself. So strategy number one is to let go of your fear of making a bad decision. Strategy number two is to turn your deepest regrets into your greatest gifts. Can you take a look at some of the regrets and find the gifts in them? We once had a woman who said she wanted to work with us, but she was afraid to sign up with another mentor because she had had a bad experience with someone else. So Jesse asked her if there were any gifts from that other program that she had signed up for. And she took a look and realized that she did actually make back more than her investment, and it wasn't all bad. Now, Jesse says he doesn't remember if she ended up joining our programs or not, but the point here is that when you take a look at the previous bad decisions you've made and you can find the gifts in them, that you'll never fear making a bad decision again, because you'll know that from every mistake comes great learnings. If you really want to release your fear of making a bad decision, do this exercise. Make a list of your 10 biggest regrets and find the gift in each of those regrets. The strategy number 2 is to turn your deepest regrets into your greatest gifts. Strategy number 3, ask yourself questions to help you make better decisions. So now that you have an empowered mindset from the first 2 strategies, it's time to get down to some practical strategies for making great decisions. So here are some questions you can ask yourself that support great decisions. Do I have all the information I need to make this decision? Sometimes the paralysis can come from trying to make a decision with missing information. So what questions can you ask that would bring clarity to the situation? Another question is, do different parts of me want different things? So for me, sometimes the coach part of me that strives for excellence and is unstoppable wants me to keep working, for example. The girl part of me wants to play, I want something different, and then the tired teenager part of me wants to rest. And since they can't agree on what they want, then I end up doing something like checking social media, which kind of appeases all 3 of them, but isn't fulfilling. It's so much more powerful to have a dialogue with all the parts of yourself and give them each a voice. And in this dialogue, you can even give them space to fully express the feelings and what they want. And after hearing from each part, you can try to find a solution that honors all of them. Now, I have a hot tip here. In this dialogue, you can also bring in your higher self as a mentor that you respect. Each of the different parts can bring a different perspective to the conversation and bring a solution that's a win for as many of the parts as possible, as well as everyone impacted by your decision. So get creative, have some fun, enjoy the process of coming into alignment with these different parts of yourself. All right, another question. Is the decision coming from love or coming from fear? Here's something to consider. The intention behind your decision is more important than the decision itself. So making a decision from love and kindness perpetuates more love and kindness. Making a decision from fear and scarcity perpetuates more fear and scarcity. For example, a while ago, someone we trusted borrowed $15,000 and then lied to us over and over and wasted many hours of our time. Things came up like, this guy's a scam artist, or we need to stand up for our family and get our money back. And after trying many times to get our money back, we had a decision to make. Did we get an attorney involved, or did we let it go? And we realized that the cost of devoting months to the fight was just far too great. We only have so much fight in us, and we'd much rather fight for a cause we believe in than fight against this guy. So we decided to let it go. Not for any other reason, except that it was the kindest thing that we could have done for ourselves, for our family, and for our community. So we took that energy and devoted it to fight for our clients to get the very best results. And that $15,000 has come back over and over again in the form of clients and partnerships, and that we would have squandered away if we had taken all of our energy and made that decision from fear and anger. So I want to ask you, are you making your decision from fear or from love? We invite you to choose love. Overcoming self-doubt and making great decisions can literally change the way you see the world. And we would be so honored to support you in doing this. If you're ready to become more confident and step into your leadership and learn some of our best strategies to help your business or your practice, we would love to invite you to join us at the next Client Attraction Summit. The summit is a 3-day live event where you'll get big breakthroughs in your confidence. You'll get a breakthrough around the most sabotaging belief you have that's preventing you from attracting your ideal clients, as well as create your crystal clear vision that magnetizes your ideal clients to you. You'll also get practical how-to skills that you can use to get more clients immediately, like sharing what you do in a compelling way that has people lean in and want to work with you, and the very best strategies that are working now to attract clients either online or offline. We'll even share strategies that our Thrive Academy members have used to earn tens of millions of dollars speaking to groups, and these strategies are essential whether you are marketing your business in person or online. Now, in the last 16 plus years, over 9,800 coaches and holistic practitioners from 29 different countries have attended. Tuition is normally $1,497, but right now we are offering scholarships to our very next Client Attraction Summit. To learn more and claim your scholarship, just click this link below or head on over to clientattractionsummit.com. We'd love to see you there and support you in reaching more of your ideal clients and getting paid well to do the work that you love. All right, hey, if you got a lot of value from this video, please give it a like and share it with other coaches or holistic practitioners who could use our help. And to learn even more, subscribe to our channel and hit that bell icon to get notified whenever we release a new video. All right, this is Sharla Jacobs signing off, because your people are waiting for you.